All right, what's going on, everybody? It's Dominic here, and today I'm back out at Stonyford, California, riding with a few friends and their kids. Right here, we're about to hop on to Trail 22. We're just coming off Trail 21, where it connects to 46, and this is where 46 intercepts Trail 22. And we're going to be headed over towards Trail 20. We're going to cross the M5, hit up 20, right about halfway to Trail 3, and then head back on 20, and then cross over the M5, and then go up 22, and then make our way down 30. But yeah, sun shining today. It's like 70 degrees. I was just out here a couple weeks ago, and this whole place was covered in snow. Now everything's kind of melting, it's dried out. A lot of the trails that are exposed are just dry and dusty, but still a fun day nonetheless. You can see snow off in the background. Stonyford, this is Trail 22. It's one of my favorite trails out here. It's been about 4 months since I've been on the trail, and it's more overgrown than the last time I've ridden it. Hopefully somebody can get out here with a hedge trimmer soon and then trim these bushes back. I love this trail, but it's steadily just slowly getting overgrown. Even though people ride it all the time, but ever since that storm closure, not the one we just had, but the one last year, ever since then it seems like all these bushes are just way overgrown. Normally I like to rip through here a lot faster. I'm not going that fast today, one, because we have some kids with us, but two, because the bushes are just so overgrown. But it is what it is. It's still a fun trail nonetheless, and one of my more favorite trails out here. 22 and 20, and then there's a handful of single tracks up by Let's Lake that I really like. But I ride 22 often. Like every time I come out to Stony, I gotta hit up 22. It's one of my favorites. Good flow, super fun trail. So if you're ever out there, hit up 22. Either direction's good to go. We had a pretty good north wind a couple weeks ago, for like 3 or 4 days straight. And since then, there's a bunch of downed trees up here on 22. So when you get into the wooded section here, there's some downed trees. I kind of bummed out about that because there's more fallen. Like every time I ride this trail, there's more downed trees. Ever since the fire damage that came through a few years ago, it just seems like every time it rains or it's windy, a tree falls over out here. But it is what it is. Still a great trail nonetheless. So we're going to get into the video. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for all your guys' support. Hit that like and subscribe button. Enjoy the trails, and we'll see you on the next one. these trees fell over. Kind of bummer. This is one of the cool spots. You're almost up to the road right there. You want to keep going?
Didn't we come from that way?
Well, that just takes you back to the M5. That goes back to the M5. This you can keep going for a little bit.
Right, this is the one we came in on, right?
No, right here.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Because we came off 22.
I don't care. Whatever.
Great to be back doing 20. Yeah.
Allergies. I'm all right.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm good. At least the ground was nice and wet there. We got lost. I was on 20 and then I see a log, and so I just charge it to go jump the log, and then next thing I know I'm back on the M5. I was like,
I saw the trail, it turned.
Oh, I saw the log jump, and I was like, oh, I'm going for it. I hopped in, and then I'm like, oh man, we're back on the road. Then I tried to get back on 20, but there was a bunch of downed trees back there. So we ended up just cutting over on 22.
I went in the puddle that was deep.